Hi, hello and welcome. It's me Vignesh here and this is your favorite BN Data channel. Today we'll be seeing some more components of Power BI. For that, let's pass on to our video.
Hi, hello, and welcome.
In our last video, we saw about data modeling in Power BI. Moving forward, today we are going to see about some of the DAX functions, that is data analysis expression in Power BI, that is called DAX functions or expressions. For that, I'm going to use an Excel worksheet that consists of ID, name, address, and salary in the data A sheet. The data B sheet, that is ID, name, salary deductions, and age. These data A and data B sheets are mocked up data by me for this video. It's not an original data from DB or any current data, it's a mocked up data or called dummy data. I had already loaded the data A and data B sheets into the Power BI desktop, as you can see now. I'm going to refresh it once again. You can see it now that salary has been added to the data A sheet, and in data B, salary deductions and age has been added. Now in modeling, we can see that there is a relationship between data A and data B in ID. So let's create a new table with the help of data A and data B. We can join them together. For that, we should move into the Power Query Editor or transform data. I'm going to merge data A and data B. Merge query as new, data B, ID, okay. I'm going to rename this table into new data AB. I'm going to expand this data B table which has been merged to data A. Since ID and name is already present in data A table, as you can see here, ID and name, I'm going to use only salary deductions and age, which is visible in data AB, new data AB. Source and expanded data B. I just now expanded data B with salary deductions and age alone, excluding ID and name. I'm going to rename this data B dot salary deductions into salary deductions, and same for data B dot age to age alone for better viewing and clarification purposes. Now I'm going to close and apply this Power Query Editor. As you can see, the query changes are being applied now. The new data AB has been created table. It consists of ID, name, address, salary deductions, and age. So, now shall we use a DAX function to calculate the salary in hand salary? I'm going to add a new column to it. It's total salary. I'm going to subtract salary minus salary deductions. As you can see, the value has been generated here. that's 100 minus 10 is 90, and 200 minus 20 is 180, and 300 minus 30 is 270. Now we separate two values. Now we shall add two values now. Hundred plus 10 is 110, 200 plus 20 is 220, and so on. This is for integer operations. Now, for the whole number operations, now we shall move on for some text oriented operations. Concatenate operation is the tax function. We can now concatenate two strings, that is name and address. You shall see now the text has been concatenated, a, and so on. The values have been concatenated now. Now we shall give some operation with if. Okay, logical test is like if address is equal to a, then if the result is true, that means that if address is a, we should print true. For anything other than that, should print false. When address A comes, it's true always. For other than anything other than WA address, it comes as false. This is like adding new columns to the data table. There is one more thing that is called a new measure. Adding new column will give you like row wise value for everything. A measure is like aggregate value of the whole column or for a whole function which we create. Suppose I am creating a function called count of rows. Okay, count of rows counts the number of entries inside this table. For this, there is only 10 entries. Let us think of a table having n number of entries. Okay, we don't know how much is an entry. For the table, we can use this count function id to get the number of as you can see here, the count measure has been created here. To see the value of the count measure, you can go to the report and a card, you can choose a card and keep the count value in that. See, the count is 10. Now, for the same count, I am using a distinct count option which only counts the distinct values. If I use the same ID in the distinct count, it will show us 10. Let's change this column name to salary. Data AB salary. So let's see. It should show 3, right? Distinct count 3. As you can see now, it counts the distinct values in that salary column. So the value is 3. Then this is what a difference between measure and a column. If I add the same value count, distinct count, as a column, it will show like for all the values it showed 3 3 3. That's the difference between aggregate. That was a measure defines. It creates an aggregate on the whole of the table. a column, add values for each rows, but aggregate function new measure will create the whole sum value of a table. Sorry, I had a table though. You know, we will not be changing the table for that. Should add a column to it. Same column. One column. See, it comes 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. If it is the same card, to represent that count column, it shows as 3. That is because in a general view it all sums up. Okay, there are many other ways, like see, sum, average, you can get average of the full column, or minimum, maximum. Since in the whole column there is only 3, 3, 3, the minimum is 3, the maximum is also 3, then count distinct values, there is only 1, as you can see here. Then count is 10 on the whole, and standard deviation is 0.00, the variance of it is also 0.00, the median of it is also 3. There are many more DAX functions like date difference, date, this is date, returns a specified date in a date time format. This is the date difference function, which gives the difference between two dates in the format of number of days in between them. It's like 90 days, 30 days or 20 days, depending upon the date chosen from and to. I'll show you more like and how AND function works, and for that I'm using a statement with AND function. Logic is that address equal to HH and you must use two AND functions, AND symbols, and name equal to H, then the result must be, if 2, the result must be H, address is double H, and if the result is false, it must return 0, correct? Expression that yield variant data type cannot be used to define calculated columns. I had specifically by knowing made a mistake there in order to see that what error comes. That is because the result is true, I gain a string or text value, that is H, address is double H, but the logic is false, it should return 0, which is a whole number. That's the reason we can't have two different data types in a single column. That's the reason it is showing error. Now, if I use the same 0 in a text format between double quotes, it will return the value. See, it is returning 0. That is because the whole column is considered as text. We can't have two different data types in a single column. And this is the AND operation. And if logic, with AND operation, this is the syntax for it. There are many more operations like NOR, NOT, and many more are there. Depending upon the need, we shall be using it on our day-to-day basis in using Power BI or any kind of BI tools mostly. Okay. Today we saw some of the DAX functions and how to write a syntax using it. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for our next video. Hellcat.